In this video, we will cover what the BioDigital platform is and how to use it in three simple steps. BioDigital is a library of fully interactive 3D resources that can be shared in multiple capacities. It can be an in-person presentation, a sales training presentation, PowerPoint, shared as a URL, embedded into websites, or embedded directly into courses. The workflow of BioDigital is three simple steps. Step one is to find the model you're looking for. Step two is to save it to my library. Step three is to publish it. You also have an optional fourth step, as we offer a customization suite called Human Studio. If you prefer to alter your model or change the information, you can customize the model in Human Studio. When you first log into the BioDigital platform, you will see the home screen. Here you will see a few different featured models, some of our What's New models, guided journeys, and other models that might be of interest to you. You can view any of these models from this screen, or you can jump right into step one, which is searching for your model. To search for your model, go to the Explore tab. You can go into any of these categories by selecting from the dropdown, or simply jump right into Explore by clicking the Explore tab. The Explore tab is where you can search from BioDigital's extensive library of models. These models include anatomy, physiology, disease, procedures, and more. There are over 850 models, and we were always adding more. And just a note, if you're curious about any of our new models, simply check out the What's New section on the home screen. Now, step one, find your model. To search the BioDigital library, you can start by browsing the categories on the left-hand side. We've separated models into different categories, including anatomy, which are separated by complete anatomy, anatomy by systems or regions, cross-sections and microanatomy, origins and insertions, and more. We also have separated models into specialties that you'll see on the left-hand side here. So you can go ahead and browse by specialty by selecting it, and then go ahead and open your model by clicking directly on the model's tile. This is where you can browse the model and take a look at what's present. You will also be introduced to what we call the human viewer. Think of the viewer as the box that the models come in. So whether they're shared as a URL or embedded directly into a website, the user experience will be the same. This experience that you see is customizable. On the left-hand side here, you'll see our info panel. All of this text that you see in the info panel is customizable in Human Studio. You can also opt to remove the info panel entirely once we get to the publishing settings, which I'll show you how to do shortly. On the bottom right, you will see some of the tools. These tools are available to your end user when the models are embedded or shared. So we have 3D navigation tools to the right. We also have explore tools, which allow the end user to hide or fade structures within the model. And then we also have tools like the draw tool, search, and anatomy tree to find specific structures. All of these tools are customizable, so if you decide you want to remove any of the tools, you can do so from the publishing settings. While searching for a model, you can also certainly use the search bar. Go ahead and type in keywords, and you'll see the models begin to filter. We also have additional filters that you can use to narrow your search. If you click filter, you can select type, level of detail, and also tags. Models come in two main types. So we have single models, or we have a tour. A tour is comprised of more than one model. And typically, tours are used to tell some sort of story. So whether it's a comparison between healthy or unhealthy, or it's a progression of a disease, or a tour through anatomy to teach anatomy concepts. Tours are comprised of more than one model. You can view each chapter of the tour by clicking the next arrow in the chapter navigation panel. You can also mix and match any of our models to create your own tour from Human Studio. To change your model's language, go ahead and click the language dropdown and select from any of the other languages that we offer. You can also sort if you'd like to sort by title, most recent, or relevance. That covers step one of the workflow. If you are new to BioDigital, I highly encourage you to browse some of our models and see what you like and what's relevant and interesting to you. Now, step two of the workflow is saving the model or adding it to my library. And think of this as making a copy of the model. You will need to make a copy before you are able to publish. There's a couple of different ways that you can add your model to My Library. You can simply hover over the model's tile and then click this plus button to add to My Library, or you can do it directly from the viewer experience. You'll see in the top right, there's a plus here. So to add to My Library, simply click the plus button. And then from here, this is where you change the model's title. You can also set permissions. So if you want the model to be private, which means that no other team members can see it, you can select private, or you can select from the team permissions, such as view only or view and edit. If your team has collections, which are effectively folders, then you can select which collections you'd like to include your model in. Then go ahead and click save. Once you've saved your model, you will see it appear in My Library. If you've saved it to the team folder, you will see it under the team folder and collection that you saved it to. Or if you saved it privately, you'll see it under your private section. Now remember, this can be changed at any time. So if you decide to save a model privately to start, you can certainly move it back to the team folder. So that covers step two of the workflow, which is adding the model. Now let's talk about My Library for a minute. My Library is where you will find all of the content that's been saved for your team. If your team has collections, you'll see them show up on the left-hand side. Collections are folders that can be used to organize your content, or you can also browse your own private library if you've saved anything privately. If you have saved content privately and you want to move it to the team folder or perhaps move it to a different collection, to do that, simply hover over the model and click the More Options button. From here, you can select Manage and then select a different permission level or a different collection. You can also change the title from here as well. Now, here's where we get into the optional step of the workflow. If you decide that you would like to customize your model, you can open the model in Human Studio. To do so, you can simply hover over the tile and select the pencil, which is customized in Studio, or you can select the pencil icon from the human viewer experience. Once you do so, this is going to open your model in our authoring suite called Human Studio. We won't talk about this too much today, but I will give you a little bit of a sneak peek into some of the capabilities of Human Studio, as well as provide a few examples for you. From Human Studio, you can do quite a bit, such as changing the appearance of the model, you can hide structures, you can apply effects, change the background color, add labels and text, and really control the narrative of the model that you're working with. To the left-hand side, you're going to see the chapter panel when you first open the model. I mentioned earlier that you're able to mix and match models to create your own tours, and this is where you would do so. So to do so, you click Add Chapter. And then you can either duplicate your previous chapter, which is really helpful if you're creating some sort of anatomy-based tour or teaching about portions of anatomy or a disease, or you can import an entirely new chapter. So what this does is it opens a window that's basically a smaller version of the Explore tab. So from here, you can browse any of the content and go ahead and import the model that you'd like to import. Once you do so, you'll see the model show up in your chapter panel. Up top, you'll see a few tools, such as Hide, which allows you to hide structures within the model, Label, which allows you to apply labels, Paint, which allows you to apply effects and colors, and Quiz, which enables you to create your own quizzes. Anytime you select any of these tools, you will see the panel to the right expand with your options. So if you select Paint, you'll see the colors and effects that you can apply. If you select Quiz, you'll be able to start adding questions. And Label will give you access to the label content, allow you to drag and drop images, and change the style and actions of the label. If you're interested in Human Studio, please make sure to check out some of our other tutorial videos that walk you through each tool and how to use it. Now I'm going to show you some examples of what's possible in Human Studio so you can get some inspiration. There are varying levels of customization that you can do within Human Studio. So it can be as simple as changing a background color and maybe changing the info panel text or a few labels. Or it could be as extensive as creating your own custom anatomy tour. That's entirely up to you and you have all the tools that you need to do so. Now for the third or fourth, depending on if you customized, final step of the workflow, we have the publishing step. So remember, the workflow is three, sometimes four, simple steps. Find, save, optionally customize, and then share or publish. You can publish your model from multiple places, including directly out of Human Studio, or you can hover over your model's tile and select the publish icon. You can also publish directly from the human viewer experience by clicking the More Options icon and selecting Publish. Once you select Publish, you will see the publishing interface. This window allows you to change some of the settings of the publish model and also export an image if that's how you choose to publish. From this window, you can do a couple of things such as copy the embed code if you're embedding directly into a website or a course like in Articulate Rise, or you can copy the URL. You can also export a high resolution image if you're using an image as well. If you're using something like PowerPoint, we typically recommend to export an image and hyperlink that image to a URL. Once models are shared or published, they do not require a login to be viewed. This means that you can simply share a URL, you can copy the embed code and embed it into your website, or you can share an image, and the end user will not have to log in to see the content. To start, we have some display options over here. These are the different tools that I mentioned earlier that you can control. So you can always test what the published experience is going to look like by interacting with the preview window that you see on the right-hand side. You'll notice that all of these options correspond to this experience. So for example, if I was to disable the information panel, you'll see that the information panel is no longer present within the model. Now, if I turn it back on, then I can view it here. We do have a Help Center article that details what all of these options are, but by default, the settings that we provide for you work perfectly fine for most purposes, but you can certainly decide to customize your experience as you prefer. Then we have some loading experience options as well. And once you have selected all of your options, including your width and height, then you can go down to either copy embed or copy URL. So if you are embedding into a website, you will copy the embed code. And what that will do is generate iframe code for you that you can then paste into your website or your course designer. If you want to copy a URL, if that's all that you need, you can do the same here. Just go ahead and click copy URL and then paste it into your medium of choice. To export an image, go ahead and select the image section of the publishing window. If you are intending to capture an image of the model, we highly recommend taking this publishing route because you can control the resolution. So from here, you can select the resolution from the dropdown, you can change the label scale, or you can disable them entirely. And then you simply just click download, and that will download a copy of the image locally to your computer. You can also copy the URL or embed code. This is going to correspond to just the image, not the 3D experience. If you do want the interactive experience, you want to make sure to go over to 3D embeddable. And that's it. That's the whole process. We'll quickly recap. So the BioDigital Human Platform is a library of 3D interactive resources that you have access to then share into your preferred location. So again, it can be a website, it can be a course, in a presentation. There's many different ways to use BioDigital models, and the workflow is a simple 3, sometimes 4-step process. Find your model by searching the library, save your model to my library, and then publish it or share it.